I'll present a topic on a relatively new industry or enterprise, which is dairy goat farming. Okay, so for this afternoon, I will have a very simple presentation consisting mainly of four major topics. Introduction, I just want to emphasize the importance and the growing interest on dairy goat production, not only in the Philippines, but in Asia, as well as in the whole world. Next, we have to look at the status of where we are in terms of dairy goat production. Siguro, if sa inyo ngayon narinig yung dairy goat, may not have tasted goat's milk, but later you will see the potential of this enterprise. And then the challenges. Since the series is about development, we have to look at the challenges as well as the strategy and approaches towards maximizing the potential of dairy goat. Okay, so let me begin with the introduction by presenting to you some statistics about dairy goats, since most of us are not familiar with this species. Okay, so from China, Australia, India, Pakistan, Iran, as well as Asian countries, I did not include the Philippines because later on you will see where we are. But look at these statistics in terms of population. India, of course, has the most number of, these are dairy goats, not the meat type. There are two types of goats, actually three, the dairy, the meat, and the fiber type. Okay. Our interest is about the dairy type. Okay. So the most number can be found in India, followed by Iran, China, Indonesia, in Asia. Okay. So there's a number of these animals for the main reason that these are under the care of the smallholder. And also when we speak of dairy goats, some of them may be used for dairy purposes probably once a year. They're not totally dedicated for dairy purpose. Okay. Now look at the milk yield. The highest can be found in China and Australia, but if you look at Asia, we're down below, not even average of 1.5. Okay. To put it in context, dairy cattle in the Philippines can produce on the average about 10 to 12 liters. Buffalo, probably about 6 to 8 liters. Dairy goats, about 1.5 in Asia. That is a high estimate. But it can reach up to 4 liters, as in the case of China. Now, the amount of milk produced is not only based on the individual capacity of the animal to produce, but as well as on the lactation period, how long they can produce milk. Okay? Ideally, it should be 9 months. Okay? But look at Asia. It's very short. Some may not even last for 3 months, and they start to dry up. Okay? So the yield per animal per year or per lactation is very small. Okay. Now let us look at the price relative to cow's milk. Now, just to give you an idea, it is about 2 times the price of cow's milk. It can go as high as 3. Australia, I see that 5 times because of its novelty in the case of Australia. But in the case of other countries, it's because of supply and demand. Others, it's because of the health benefits. So there are many reasons why the price of goat milk relative to cow's milk varies. Okay, now why, how important is dairy goat production now? Okay, in 2012, stakeholders within Asia, Australasia, those that are in the academe, in the research institutions, realize the importance of dairy goats, especially for smallholders. And so they put up this Asian Australasian Dairy Goat Network, okay, to promote dairy goat farming in Asia, Australasia. It invites all stakeholders, academics, researchers, private individuals, anybody who are interested with dairy goats. So it's a loose organization. Although it has held already two conferences, okay, to gather information, share knowledge about dairy goat, and in so doing promote dairy goat production and research. We are part of this network, and hopefully with our development in dairy goat production, we will be contributing to this network more substantially in the future. So the third conference will be in China. The last conference was in Indonesia. That's the reason why I was here, because SEARCA granted me a travel grant to attend this conference. Okay, locally, I think you have heard all of this. According to Secretary Monteo, I don't know if you will believe this, but according to him, goats can turn the country into a land of milk in 2 years. Sana. The goat that many of us believe that is actually a gold mine. So this is a very optimistic pronouncement from the Secretary of Science and Technology. So Picard, which is the research arm of USD in agriculture, will implement a 3-year project with the aim of the following. By producing, according to them, by producing goat's milk, we will ease the country's importation of milk. Second, according to Picard, goat's milk is healthier for babies and senior citizens like you, more financially rewarding. But when it comes to these targets, increase milk yield in backyard farms from 45 liters in 90 days to 135 liters in 180 days, and in commercial farms from 360, which means a yield increase of 150% in almost 3 years. I doubt very much if we can attain that. But let us be optimistic anyway. Okay, so that is more or less to give us an idea of how important dairy goat farming now within the region and in the Philippines. So it's very timely that we look at this enterprise. Okay, very quickly, let us look at the dairy industry as a whole. As we all know, we still import 99% of our dairy requirements, skim milk, fresh milk, UHT, and so forth, valued at $47 million annually. Local production of milk from dairy cow, buffalo, goat, accounts for a mere 0.04% of the total agricultural production. That's how small the dairy industry is. And that is only 0.23% of the livestock production coming from swine, poultry, and other livestock products. So, how about the dairy goat? Now, in the past, from 1970 to 1980, we had a large importation of Anglo-Nubian under the program Kambingan sa Barangay during those martial law years. And the farmers were attracted to upgrade their native goats with the good, nice features of the Nubian, the long ears, Roman nose. So talagang gustong-gusto nila. They were looking for that Anglo-Nubian. But the purpose of upgrading was towards goat meat production. But remember, the Anglo-Nubian is a dairy type. It's not for meat. But we use it for meat production anyway. So there is paucity of information with regards to the performance of imported dairy goats. Hindi tayo nag-research sa dairy goats. When I was still a student, way back 1970s, I know only of Dr. Clamuhoy, Professor Clamuhoy, and another who are raising dairy goats. Now, other than that, of course, we have Selecta. Those of you who remember Selecta Dairy, sila talaga nagde-dairy goats sila ever since. Pero other than that, wala na ako alam. At present, there are renewed interest on the supposed to be financial viability of goat milk production. Kasi nga, mahal eh. Twice the amount, twice the price of cow's milk. And then the awareness on the benefits of goat milk. Marami yan. I will deal with that. And then, somehow there's application of science in breeding and nutrition, which is a good sign, maturity on the part of our farmers, that they are now consulting with the academe, the research institutions, with regards to new developments in these disciplines. Okay? Commercial dairy goat farmers are highly selective of the breeders that they import, because dairy goat production is mainly private-led. They import themselves. So talagang pinipili nila yung magandang packs with records for their improvement. Unfortunately, there is lesser government support vis-a-vis the other milk sources. We have the PCC for buffalo, we have the NDA for cattle, but nothing for dairy goat. It is with the BAI, they say, but just to say, there's no dedicated institution that looks after the goat, the dairy goat in particular. As I've said, it is mainly private sector then, which is good. Okay, never mind this. This will just show you where the goats are, the meat type, and where the dairy goat farms are located. Batangas, Tarlac, Sorsogon, Parami, Camarines Norte, Davao, Misamis Oriental, North Cotabato, in Mindanao. In Cebu, there are some in Negros Occidental, as well as Cebu. Okay. How many dairy goats do we have? As of 2013, there were 39,000 dairy animals. Cattle, buffalo, and the goats. Okay. When the total numbers of cattle, buffalo, and goats were decreasing, if you look at the total population of these species, those being used as dairy animals increased by 27%. Okay. So in this table, if you look at the total dairy animals belonging to cattle, buffalo, and goats, they increased by 27% from 2006 to 2012. But if you look at the total cattle population, there's a decrease of 1%, but the dairy type cattle increased by almost 38%. Total buffalo decreased by 13%, but the dairy type buffalo, the Miura buffalo, increased by 13%. Goat also decreased, although very small, but look at the increase in the dairy goat, 30%. So that means the interest of dairy among our stakeholders. Okay, so increases in particular for dairy cattle and buffalo can be attributed mainly to importation. Okay, every year, for example, NDA imports about 1,002 dairy cattle. Batch 13 will arrive soon, and that's about another 1,200. So, there's an increase. And then, of course, renewed interest by the private sector in the case of dairy goats. Nowadays, it's very difficult to buy breeder goats, breeder dairy type goats, because there are many buyers of this animal. Yeah, unfortunately, there's some confusion about the dairy goat population. According to NDA, in 2013, there's only 1,638. PCAR, which also got its data from NDA, said there was 6,379. NDA in 2014 said 7,200 with 3,244 does. I think all these numbers were correct. It's only the what you call that nomenclature. Na sinabi nila itong 1,638 does. These were the does, yung mga babae. Okay. Ito naman sa Picard, yung 600 on milk. Sabihan na sa milk line, kinagatasan. So, iba-iba kasi yung kinagamit na term. But, personally, I'd like to think that we have about 4,000 dairy goats only in the Philippines. Compare that to other Asian countries that I've shown you earlier in the table. And this table shows you the number of goats. It's really small. But these are, as I said, the does rather than total number of dairy goats. I hope you know what are those bucks. Okay, so out of the total population of goat, there's only 0.11% that are dairy type. Napakakaunti. That's only about 4,000 out of 3.7 million. But as I said, they're increasing at 38%. But even then, napakabagal pa rin yan. If we start with a small base number. Cattle 0.8, buffalo 0.5. So altogether, our dairy animals is about 1.4% of the total ruminant population in the Philippines. That is why we import 99% of our milk. Okay, so out of 39,000 dairy animals, goat 4%, dairy cattle 55%, buffalo 41%. Okay, so this is now the herd composition of a typical dairy goat farm. So this is the buck, the male, the breeder male. Those are the females. Those on milk are lactating, and kids, yung mga anak. Okay. So half of the herd are those. 80% are the breeder bucks. Those on the milk line increased during the last 3 years. No? Dito nag-increase yung pumapasok sa milking line. Probably with better nutrition, there are more those that are in the milking line. So, in summary, typical dairy goat herd composition, 55% does, 43% the milk line, the large dairy farms, 50 to 150 does, small dairy farms, 10 to 20 does. So you can just imagine if you have a small dairy farm of 10 does, only half of that will be 43% of that will be milking. About 4 out of 10 are being milked. The other 6 are either pregnant, dry, or non-pregnant. So that's how unproductive our typical herd is. Okay, in terms of total milk production, 18.1 million liters from cow, parabal, and look at goat's milk, 260,000 liters. Okay, so that's a mere 1.4% of the total milk that was produced, 65% coming from cattle, 34% coming from buffalo. So this is the production. This was based on the NDA industry profile, based on the number of goats, the milk line. They measured the production, 1,000 liters. So I divided this by the number of goats to get liters per goat per lactation. Although, as I've said, as we have seen before, lactation can last from as short as 60, 90 days to as long as 300 days. So we do not know really how productive these animals were. Okay. But what is important here is that milk production per doe increased from 2009 to 2011. So there's an improvement in individual animal. And it should be emphasized that if we want really development in dairy goat farming, or even in cattle or dairy cow, it should be improvement per animal rather than total. That is why it's very difficult to implement. Okay. We also have some commercial dairy farms. Okay, Alamina's goat farm just across the Mount McKinley on the other side. Okay, good genetics. This is one of the more progressive commercial goat farms. The Mindanao Baptist Rural Life Center is one of the oldest dairy goat farms in North Cotabato. Bansalan, and actually there's a major source of genetics way back 1970s until present. We have the Malacos Goat Farm, although it is more known for the gourmet cheeses that they produce. I mentioned here in our daily goat co-op, because it is an LGU, what they call that, auto. That's their auto. And they produce a lot of soap, fresh milk, and other goat products. Sweets, candies. Okay, breeds of dairy goats. Very quickly, we have the native goat. Let's forget about it. You just produce 66 kilograms in 187 days, so very small, so it's not a daily type. It's not a daily type. The purebreds, these were believed to be introduced as early as during the Spanish colonization. That's why we have this, the youngest group. For those who are aware of this, this, the youngest group, General Santos now, was formed out of the importation during those earlier times, sa Anen, ang Lubian. Unfortunately, we cannot find it anymore, but at least in my lifetime, I saw it. It's a beautiful animal. I don't know wala na yan. So it's a cross, probably of Lubians, Alpine, and sa Anen. So now, here in the Philippines, we have these purebreds. Okay, Anglo-Nubians, Anen, Tokenberg, Alpine, La Mancha, Cocker Husky. Okay, these are dairy type animals. Most of them are from Switzerland. So goats are from the cold environment, but they can live also in deserts. Nubians are desert type. They call it Anglo because we cross it with the English goats. They are looking Anglo-Nubian. So they can drive from the desert to the highest Alps. That's how adaptable goats are to different environments. So these are the pictures. They're very beautiful animals, the Anglo-Nubian. They give the Over Husky, you know, Over Husky is a word, it's a marketing word probably among Americans, but it's actually Alpine. La Mancha, which is without ears. La Mancha is characterized without ears. Sanen, these are the white goats, the highest producer among dairy goats. And then they cross. Sanen Alpine, Sanen Anglo. Never mind this. Management system, very quickly. Most of the dairy goats are raised in confinement on elevated houses. Okay. For the simple reason, for the control of worms and respiratory diseases. So if you want to raise dairy goats, they should be raised on elevated floor. Feeding system. Now, remember, goats are mainly browsers. They are not grazers. So it means that about 70-60% of their diet should be herbs or browse, the broad leaves, and only about 40-30% should be grasses. If we feed them all grasses, mabubuhay siguro sila, but they are not happy. They want variety. We have seen pictures of goats feeding on barks rather than on leaves. Because they're in search of minerals. If you will look at goats, there is no such thing as goat fattening, because goats do not fatten. Huwag niyo sasabihin goat fattening, baka may ganung proposal dito gawin. Because that's why goats are very active animals, no? They have to jump and run around to expend energy. Yeah. Ganun ang goats, kaya sila malikot. Okay? And then, so the feed should be mainly legumes. Because that is, legumes are browse plants. Okay? And there's a very large contribution of Mindanao Baptists, because they were the ones who popularized or too and introduced all of these popular leguminous herbs and shrubs nowadays. So, lately, there's indigofera. Indigofera, as we all know, is used for the production of dye, indigo. Pero gustong-gusto rin ang ano, ang kambing. Limitia, not as palatable, but very drought-resistant. Morus alba and Gans kajan pigeon bee is a potential feed for dairy goats. Morus alba, worldwide. Pero we tried it, mahina ang yield. So probably it's a species problem. Health management, ito, veterinarian yield. Kahe, cochrane arthritis, encephalitis. Ito yung isang problema ng health problem. In-import din natin itong sakit na ito. Imported din natin. And, it adversely affects development of the dairy goat industry kasi mahirap mag-transport. Kailangan i-test mo before you can buy from Mindanao and bring it here. They should be negative. Although pagdating dito, may isang positive test. So anyway, there's still some issues. Pero it's a major concern, not only in the Philippines, also in other Asian countries. Then of course, the common pneumonia, mastitis, contagious eczema, then parasites. Okay? Okay, marketing. I think nowadays consumers are, especially those who are sick and elderly, are aware of the nutritional characteristics of goat's milk. They are easily digestible, non-allergenic. Okay. So, talaga maganda sa katawan, masarap, matamis. So, yung recent reports, especially in England, there's a lot of health bulletins, health reports about the benefits of goat milk. Okay, entrepreneurs engaged in dairy goat are expanding production and market. Yung goaty odor of, or flavor of goat milk is not the major concern, no, according to some survey. Kasi it can easily be masked by chocolate milk yan. May chocolate milk na yan in goat. But anyway, that has to do something with milking practices. Okay, pasteurized goat milk sells at 150 compared to cow's milk, it was 75, some 80, so twice the price of cow's milk in the Philippines. Cheeses made of goat milk sells 50% more than those processed using cow's milk. The problem here is, of course, is when you make cheeses, the yield is very small. To produce Camembert or blue cheese, I think the yield is only 8%, 10%. So you need 1 liter of milk to just produce 100 grams. So very expensive. That's very nice. And that's the price, farm gate price. Increase in Mababa, that is 2011. Okay, challenges. As usual, availability of winter stocks. Lack of breeding plan. Discriminate cross breeding. Maganda ito, bago itong video na ito, cross ko dito. Without regards to plan. Inadequate nutrition because of lack of plan. So, weak biosecurity measures, fragmented and limited researches on dairy goat farming, and organized marketing system. As of now, kanya-kanyang marketing. Walang organized marketing system. Okay. So, the challenges na yan, ever since ganyan yan. What is more important is how do we address these problems. Okay, I think the development strategy should be based on wider appreciation of the potential of dairy goats. I think the stakeholders, in general, the public, should be aware of the potential, especially the government policy makers, the potential of dairy goats. We should be able to articulate this importance of dairy goats. And then better resource use, land, feeds, and genetics. Kulang pa tayo, especially in the propagation of leguminous pastures. Very limited pa rin ang ating knowledge dyan. Should be based on strong interdisciplinary and community-based approaches. Should be community-based, as we will see later on, because most of these animals are in the hands of smallholder farmers anyway. And there should be clear government policy and strong institutional support. Okay? Now, what are the development approaches? As I've said, should be community-based, especially in the breeding program, breed recording system. Okay. Should be a two-pronged development approach, catering to the smallholder and the commercial. Because there are differences between the two, although they are equally important in the development of the industry. One cannot exist without the other. Then there should be promotion and marketing of goat's milk. Strict adherence to control measures and quarantine procedures. Control kae and other diseases. Walang pangsud dapat. Engagement of LGUs to adopt dairy goat farming as a priority livelihood project. LGUs have money for this dairy goat project, which is very good for small farmers. Okay, the only way forward. This is the only way forward. We already have this. Dairy goat breeders and farmers. We have not AI, but we import the box. Pero wala tayo nito. You know, if we compare cattle, caravan with swine and poultry, how advanced at the soy and poultry industries compared to ruminants. Hindi makausad ang ruminant because we don't have this. Kahit na anong gawin importation yan, as long as wala yan, walang mangyayari sa ating ruminant industry. Okay. Kahit na taon-taon mag-import tayo ng bulls, whatever. Kasi pag ginamit yan dyan, nananak, maganda, o pagdireta yan, wala na. There is no improvement. As I've said before, the improvement should be based on individual animals, no? Individual performance. So, yung top 10%, kunin natin. Yun ang gamitin natin. With time, pag ikot ng ikot yan, you will have elite herd. Magiging parang bawian, lego na rin. Magkakamukha na yung kambing. Diba? Ang tawag ng tawag yan. Like, ganun talaga yun. No? That is why, yun nga, yung cattle, beef cattle natin, hanggang ngayon, ganun pa rin. Ang carabao natin, dapat huwag nung pakailanan yan. Let the carabao stand as carabao. Huwag na natin gawin new rayon. Carabao na yan. So, dapat may action plan. No? I just give an example. Our objective is to increase the milk yield of dairy goats. How? We can only increase the yield of dairy goats if the farmers will only raise goats with estimated breeding values. Ibig sabihin, may genetics yung inaalagaan ng farmers. But how will they get goats with breeding values? Dapat may magsusupply. May breeders. But how will they produce that? There should be well-organized breeding and recording center. It can be government, it can be private, or semi-government. But whatever it is, it should be there. Otherwise, kung wala yan, ikot lang ng ikot yan. So, without selection, without, you go to status quo. There should be movement, the mean of the production. The target, 5 to 10 years, we want to organize this. Then we measure it, pagka 25% of the goat farmers, yung meron ng goats ngayon, kung 25% na sa kanila meron ng progeny tested, sabihin na natin we are successful. But that will not take, sabi nila, 2017. Even with this, we will not increase milk yield by 150%. Even with selection during the next 10 years. At present, we do not know how much, what is the average milk yield. Some say 1.5. I doubt it's 1.5. Siguro, nasa 0.8 lang. So, we want to increase it by 100%. That's 1.6. Kasi ang usapan dito, average, hindi yung one part. Meron siyang part, talagang 3 kilos, 3 liters kaya during the peak. But not during the whole lactation period. Okay, so with that, we have new recent initiative. As I've said, USDP card launched its 3-year dairy goat project. But what I heard is that it's just a survey for the first year. And by 2017, 150% increase. The Small Ruminant Research and Development Center at CLSU. This used to be dedicated to meat goat production, but now they're shifting to dairy. That's how important dairy is. We have here in our own backyard, the UPLB, UNACO Dairy Goat Research Project. 2 years na kami, ganun pa rin, meron nahirap pa rin. So it's very difficult. No? And then, let us participate in the Asian-Australasian Dairy Goat Network. So we can share, exchange information, gain knowledge from our counterparts. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sevilla, for walking us through the development and growth of goat farming in the Philippines, as well as the status and challenges faced by the industry here in our country. So the floor is now open for your insights, your comments, or questions. Please use the microphones along the aisle and kindly identify by yourself and the organization you represent. I'm going to throw in the first question. Yeah, please.
Sir, from UNB staff. Is data processing center, may ginagawa bang actions ng government natin sa pag-develop ng data processing center ng gold product, gold milk production in the Philippines?
I think there's some initiative, no? But there's nothing to process anyway. Kasi wala pa naman recording. Wala pa tayong recording system. There are farms recording, no? Recording the milk yield, but these are not being processed in a centralized manner. Kasi we want improvement. It should be the whole population, hindi yung farm lang. Maraming nga dyang farm, magaganda na eh. Pero kung ganda lang yun. Ang gusto natin, yung national average natin, just like Australia, France, and other countries, ang average nila, tataas. Pagka bumili ka ng kambing, assured ka na it will produce. Kasi meron siyang parang guarantee, no, based on records. So yun ang gusto natin mangyari. Kasi ngayon, mahirap mag-invest. Hindi mo alam kung makukuha mong kambing. Baka bigyan ka lang ng kalating dito araw-araw. Ang mahal-mahal ng kambing. It's about 15,000-20,000 each. You know, 7 months, 8 months old. Breedable. Now, that's how expensive breeders are. Contribution towards meat, goat meat production. Huwag na natin sila isali sa dairy production.
So, for the dairy goat industry, we will forever be dependent on importation?
Hindi. Dapat nga, hindi na tayo nag-importer with the number of, kailangan na selection, no? Multi-breed selection, siguro. That's why, ang dami natin geneticists dito, walang magawa eh. Dapat din ang ginagawa nila eh.
Geneticists talaga.
Totoo lang. If we look at other countries, ano, kasi they all start with breed society. Okay? Sa Anen, ang Peruvian, ang cattle, Brahman, di ba? Kanya-kanyang breed society, kaya natin develop yung breed. But in this case, nag-import na tayo, mga purebreds, supposedly, quote-unquote purebreds, isi-reka na natin. Kasi the other consideration here is that dairying is not an easy enterprise. It's a 24/7, highly complex, labor-intensive, capital-intensive system. Pero that's not mean to say na hindi natin sasali smallholder. Ang role ng smallholder is for rural nutrition. Yung commercial for commercial market. Okay? So, sabi nga, two prongs, siguro yung native will have something to do with the rural development program. Kaya, trabaho niyo yun as geneticist. Huwag ako tanungin niya kasi. Pero that's a problem that I
And that's the model that we saw in Taiwan. they import purebreds, but they do local selection and breeding. So they develop their local breeds pa rin. Parang ganun, sir. So I hope ganun din mangyari sa Philippines.
Yes, sir. Hey, sir. Masabeo po for my own science. Record keeping or recording would be a bit difficult if you ask the farmers to do it. But I suppose we have ECUs, containing both farms. We have, I think, every region having animal breeding farms. Maybe from there we could start that approach of establishing recording.
Yes. Actually, that's our dream. Kasi ang sinasabi nila, mahirap kasi you have to collect milk yield per animal. Mahirap daw yun. Siguro mahirap, pero it has not to be every day. There is a convention, yung international convention on animal recording, that you get it only every 3 weeks. And that will represent the lactation period. Kasi ang misconception ay, mahirap yan, araw-araw, kukunan namin. Hindi natin may paliwanag sa kanila na will only be on interval of 3 weeks. And you select only the animals that you want to register. Hindi lahat kukunan. Dapat, and it's true, no? NDA, may mga records na, di ba? Kahong-kahon. So, ang gagawin mo doon? Sinong gagawa nyo? So it's not being utilized. So if we will collect records, dapat we will process it. Huwag na tayo mag-collect kung hindi natin pa-process. Simple as that. Meron kami ginawa nila Gigi, funded by BAR, we develop a recording system na bigay namin sa farmers na babalik dito sa UP, no? Through web. Wala nang pera, so pahinga muna. Pero let's try it. We are trying. I think, as I said, that's the only way forward. Other than that, it's been a short time.
Hello, sir. Second team up from UPLB. Is the weather condition of the Philippines even favorable for growth? Good production and the
yung climate that can be manipulated, as we have seen in swine and poultry, no? Meron ang tunnel bed as a general condition. Itong goats, okay naman sila, wag lang sila maugulanan. They can tolerate basta magandang housing, magandang ventilation, they can tolerate it. Although, of course, meron konting sacrifice sa yield, no? That will be manageable. Kasi may advantage naman tayo sa proteins, year-round ng plant production natin. Wala tayong winter. So, atas lang. Sabi nga, tabla-tabla lang.
You mentioned that goat's milk is a healthy milk and it's good for babies. Pero kung masyado pong mataas yung kanyang price, so paano po natin siya i-market at paano po natin mag-convince that mothers try this kind of milk kasi mas healthy siya kaysa dun sa cow's milk?
As of now, parang niche, ano lang yan eh, para sa lactose intolerant ang market niya. Pero siyempre, although we do not patronize the bottle feeding, di ba, hindi naman natin gusto yun, kundi hindi dapat natin sila pinapasuso sa bote. But for those who have problems with digestion, with cow's milk, this is the alternative. Parang ganun sa mga. But if we look worldwide, ang goat milk talaga is designed for cheese. Talagang cheese ang product.
Raymond Catanda from SEM UPN. I'm very excited that the potential of this dairy goat enterprise, you know, is being neglected, okay, in this country. And you have said that there is a high importation of dairy goat, you know? And we all know that this 2015 we will be joining with this ASEAN, okay, 2015. And because of this, perhaps we will be facing with this problem of this importation. My question is this: can we compete with this imported product, particularly this smallholder?
There is nothing for us to compete with, no, kasi wala naman tayong production talaga. But yung kasing market doon sa rural, ano yun eh, parang it's more of a development approach. No? It's not for commercial approach. Para sa nutritional improvement. No? Parang approach yun eh, rural nutrition. Parang subsidized. No? Ang game mo ron, sa Millennium Development Goal, is rural nutrition, improvement in rural nutrition, no? Rather than pera. But of course, if there is success, there's money in it. No? Pero yung commercial natin, there's a market for, a very small market for finished products. No? Cheeses, raw milk, fresh milk, meron yun. Although not that big, aminin natin. Pero anyway, it's an opportunity nga, sabi ko. It's not for everybody, but it's an opportunity as an industry.